Hello everyone, a shout out to everyone who is supporting the channel, thanks. Defeatism is the acceptance of defeat without struggle, often with negative connotations. According to mainstream philosophy, defeatism is closely related to pessimism. However, there are situations in which the adoption of a defeatist mindset is the only logical thing to do. Our existence, with its sinister nature, is an example of one such situation. The fact is that our existence is literally that of cattle. We are being relentlessly farmed without realizing it. We are inside the body of a soul-devouring, immensely large creature of an unimaginable-to-us size. There is an entire macro-world out there of staggering proportions. In the big scheme of things, we are much more insignificant than we can imagine. And even though there are many people who have a mentality based on a fighting spirit, the fact remains that our situation is as hopeless as it can be. But it's not the actual hopelessness of our situation that is the only problem here. The real problem is people's inability to embrace a zero-hope outcome on the subject of our existence as a real possibility. Embracing the worst-case scenario doesn't need to be a bad thing, especially not when properly processed. In fact, there are many benefits to the full acceptance of a zero-hope outcome. For example, getting rid of various unsubstantiated concepts can have a liberating effect. Having no expectations equals having no disappointments. And a life without disappointments is a life full of joy. The full and unconditional acceptance of a zero-hope outcome is a recipe for joy and even happiness. Adopting a defeatist mindset would be the only true representation of reality. It is impossible for us to fight our unimaginably powerful and evil creator entities. So the only realistic state of mind has to be based on defeatism. The truth is that there are no such things as heaven, hell, eternal life, etc. Our existence is a cold-blooded one. And even though distracting ourselves with all of the non-existing religious or atheistic concepts can provide a certain driving force, it still won't fill the hole left by the obvious and tangible, grim-looking facts of reality. Because consciously or subconsciously, we are aware of the fact that our existence is nothing but bad news. Our short and miserable lives won't be actually prolonged by hopeful and optimistic concepts. Optimism and hopefulness have poisonous effects. They make sure that we get stuck in a state of continuous suspension. And by doing that, we become oblivious to the sinister facts of reality. And even though there is a lot of truth in the saying, ignorance is bliss, there is no going back once you become aware of and awake to the harsh truth about our existence. And the value of a defeatist mentality can only be experienced when it comes to issues that are beyond our control. The nature of our existence is such an issue. There is nothing we can do about our impending deaths. And a mindset based on a fighting spirit is therefore unnecessary. Of course, there is nothing wrong with having a fighting spirit when it comes to all other aspects of life. But the only logical approach on the subject of our existence is having a defeatist mentality. There is no point to fight the invincible. We are being relentlessly farmed by our own and evil gods, and we can't reason with them. We are literally cattle. We are a part of the livestock within this soul farm of a world, and there is nothing we can do to change that. It happens to be the nature of our existence. Also, it's not really possible to put aside the truth and to just go back into believing the various indoctrinations we successfully shook off in the first place. So, even though there are negative connotations to the very firm defeatism, it still is the only suitable mindset when it comes to the subject of our existence. A defeatist mentality is not recommendable in most other aspects of life, but on the subject of our existence is definitely a key ingredient for a joyful and happy life, especially for the awakened people among us. Full acceptance of a zero-hope outcome on the subject of our existence may sound rather horrible to those who are under the spell of religious indoctrination. It even sounds horrible to most other people, including atheists and other heliocentric believers. There are even people who are aware of the fact that we are inside the body of a soul-eating macro-creature of immense proportions, and they still have trouble accepting the cold-blooded reality for what it is. Either way, there is always the survival instinct that is a part of our bioengineering, and that's what's making it difficult for most people to adopt a defeatist mindset by fully accepting a zero-hope outcome on the most important matter of all, which is the matter of our existence. Personally, I have been able to overcome the difficulties of adopting a defeatist mindset, and I have been able to realize its value and to benefit from it.